this month of July, the Lord will put laughter in your mouth. This month of July, the Lord will put laughter in your mouth. This month of July, the Lord will give you a testimony. In the name of Jesus. Somebody shout amen. Hallelujah. You're welcome to the month of July. Hallelujah. The month of your laughter. The month of your laughter. You will laugh again in the name of Jesus. You will laugh again in the name of Jesus. I say you will laugh again in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout amen. Holy Bible, shake me, Barash. Libranda, Prudy, Caprani, and Kosi, Calabala. The Lord will put testimony in someone's mouth this morning. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This morning I'll be preaching the topic titled The Giving Power. Tell everybody, giving power. Tell your neighbor the giving power. Tell yourself the giving power. Last week we preached on the topic of believers and the world. Believers and the world. We are not of this world. The person that we are not of this world, we have a part to play in this planet. Praise God. What is that part that everyone must play is to cover the earth with the gospel of the kingdom. And you cannot cover the earth with the gospel of the kingdom without money. Praise God. I said, praise God. That is a money answering all things. So this morning we're going to be talking or preaching on a topic titled The Giving Power. The Giving Power. Many people expect a miracle, they expect to receive but don't want to give. There is a force that enables you to manifest in a new realm. There's a force that helps you or enables you to manifest in a new realm of life. There is a power to get wealth. There's a power to succeed. There's a power to prosper. And that power is a product of giving power. That power is a product of giving power. There is a force that enables you to manifest in a new realm of life. There is a power to get wealth. That power is a product of giving power. Somebody say giving power. That the power to let down is what provokes the power to receive. The power to let down is what provokes the power to receive. If you cannot let down something, don't expect to receive anything. Let's quickly look at the book of Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 18. Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 18, I'm reading from Living Translation. Praise God. Remember the Lord your God. He is the one who gives you power to be successful in order to fulfill the covenant he confirmed to your ancestors in Abraham. Then he just said, remember the Lord your God, it is him that giveth you power to make wealth. It is him that giveth you power to get wealth. It is him that giveth you power to create wealth. Praise God. You cannot make it in life without God. You cannot succeed without the Almighty God. Power to succeed is tied to the world. Praise God. The power to let down is what provokes the power to receive. Jesus said in John chapter 10, verse 17, Jesus said, tell God that I did that. Let's look at John chapter 10. Praise God. John chapter 10 verse 17. John 10 17. Praise God. Jesus said, the Father loves me because I sacrifice my life so I may take it back again. The Father loves me because I sacrifice Amen.
Amen.
I was trying to read from King James. That's why I was a bit confused.
The devil told my father, love me, because I let her my life, that I might take it again.
The father loves me because I laid down my life, I will take it again. That's King James.
It is sleeping behind the power to get wealth. You want to get wealth on earth, want to succeed, you must learn how to let down.
You must learn how to succeed. No farmer succeed without sowing. No planter succeed without sowing. That a seeder in that harvest time will not cease. Praise God. It is simply behind the power to get wealth until the power to let things down begins to work in your life. The power to receive will not get in motion.
Until the power to let things down begins to work in your life, the power to receive will not go into motion. There's nothing called rain in the atmosphere.
They want to be prosperous. They want to buy heaven and earth. But they don't want to sow. They don't want to lay down. Prayer does not bring prosperity. Prayer does not bring wealth. It is the power to lay down that brings wealth. Rain cannot fall without evaporation. Let's take a look at Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 3. Rainfall is a product of evaporation. If the cloud be full of rain, they empty themselves upon the earth.
So as you start giving, keep giving, continue giving, a day will come that all your giving, God will return them back to you.
God will tell men to sow back your life. So when you lay your hands, it prospers. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 3. Say, if the cloud be full of rain, this King James. Say, if the cloud be full of rain, they empty themselves upon the earth. They empty themselves upon the earth. Let's see other translation from New Living Translation. Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 3. Let's see from New Living Translation. So when clouds are heavy, the rains come down. Whether a tree falls north or south, it stays where it falls. If the cloud be full of rain, they empty themselves upon the earth. If nothing goes up from you, don't expect anything to come down to you. If nothing goes up from you, don't expect something to come down. Many people get frustrated today because they are believing that people will help them, will support them, but they don't want to support someone else. Don't expect help when you don't help people. Don't expect help. For every farmer, there's a planting season. And for every farmer, there's a harvest season. When you don't plant when others are planting, you don't have something to harvest when others, you won't have something to harvest when others are harvesting. That is why for you to succeed here on earth, before we make heaven, you must be a sower, you must be a giver. You must be a sower, you must be a giver. Make sure that giving is part of your life. Make sure that you are a giver, make sure you are a sower, make sure you are a tither. for you to succeed here on earth. Why? You cannot succeed by your struggles. You cannot succeed by your expertise. You cannot succeed by whatever degree you have acquired. You can only succeed by the power of God. The Bible saying in the chapter 8, verse 15, that it is God that giveth thee power. Power to make wealth. Power to create wealth. I pray as the Lord gives you grace to give, you will experience harvest in the name of Jesus. You will experience harvest in the name of Jesus. Beloved, if nothing goes off from you, don't expect anything to come down to you. Why? The Bible says, if the cloud be full of rain, if the cloud be full of rain, the earth themselves upon the earth, keep sowing, keep giving. One day your harvest will come. One day someone somewhere will remember you for good. One day someone somewhere will remember you for favor. Someone say, amen. Let's bring look at 2 Corinthians 8:1-9. 2 Corinthians 8, verse 1 to 9. 2 Corinthians, quickly. 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 1 to 9. Praise God. So now I want you to know, dear brothers and sisters, Living Translation, what God in His kindness has done through the churches in Macedonia. They are being tested by many troubles. They are being tested by many troubles, and they are very poor, not even rich. But they are also filled with abundant joy, which has overflowed in rich generosity. For I can testify that they and they did it of their own free will, not by compulsion. By their own free will, they began to sow, not because pastor said give. They began to sow, not because someone asked them to give. They began to sow, they began to give at their own will. Verse 4, they beg us again and again for the privilege of sharing in the gift of the believers in Jerusalem. They began to bring soul to the city of Jerusalem. They even did more than we had hoped. For their first action was to give themselves to the Lord and to us, just as God wanted them to do. So we have urged Titus, who encouraged your giving in first place, to return to you and encourage you to finish this ministry of giving. Since you excel in so many ways, in your faith, your gifted speakers, your knowledge, your enthusiasm, and your love for us, I want you to excel also in this precious act of giving. I am not commanding you to do this, but I am testing you. I'm testing how genuine your love is by comparing it with the eagerness of other churches. So you know the generous grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, though He was rich, yet for your sake He became poor, so that you, by His poverty, He could make you rich. Jesus was rich. He became poor. He gave His life. He died for you, so that you can be rich. Praise God. Someone say, I am rich. I cannot be poor. Say, Lord, I refuse to be poor on earth. Give me grace to be a giver. Give me grace to be a sower into your kingdom. In the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say amen. Amen. Somebody shout amen. Amen. Beloved, once your cloud is full of rain, once your cloud is full, your rain will fall and no devil can stop it. It's because you have refused to give that word which is a wizard and accusing you. That the devil's spirits are hindering your miracles. Lord said in Malachi, said, bring me all the tithes into the storehouse, that there might be meat in my house, and prove me now, if I will not open the window of heaven and pray at the blessing, that there will not be room enough to receive. Say, and I will impute the character work, the caterpillar and the power work for yourself. I will impute the devil. I will impute your enemies.
witch, no wizard can stop a giver. No witch or wizard, no principality, no ancestral causes can stop a giver. You're still where you are because you have refused to give. You are still where you are because you are shying away in sowing into the kingdom work. You are shying away in giving to the poor. You are shying away in giving to your pastors, giving to those who are in need, to the less privileged and the less marginalized. Praise God. Once your cloud is full, your rain will fall and no devil can stop it. Some Christians don't express their rainfall until they die. Why? Because they refuse to give. They don't express their abundance, they don't express prosperity, they don't express expansion, they don't express harvest on the dead. Why? Because they don't want to give, they don't want to sow. Once you talk about giving and sowing, you offend them. Once you talk about giving, talk about sowing seed into the kingdom, things only if you come and those ones, they keep prospering, they keep succeeding. The Bible says that the rich get richer and the poor gets poorer. Why is it that the rich is getting richer and the poor is getting poorer? Because the poor is always saying, I don't have, I am poor, I don't have what to eat today. Baby Lord, you can even give your last card. A widow gave her last coin and the Lord noticed it and prospered her. The widow said, man, gave her last card and God multiplied her blessing. You need to give for you to live in affluence here on earth before we go to heaven. Givers never lack. Somebody say, givers never lack. Somebody say, givers never lack. Why is the poor getting poorer and the rich getting richer? We read about the Macedonian church. They came out of poverty. They came out of poverty and the Lord blessed them. Today, many of us, we quote Philippians 4:19 out of context. My God shall supply all my needs according to the teaching in glory by Christ Jesus. But yet, they don't read the part before verse 19. They don't read verse 18, they don't read 17, they don't read 18, they don't read 20. They just go to verse 19. My God shall supply all my needs according to the teaching in glory by Christ Jesus. They keep quoting and quoting. Years are going, passing by. 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, you are still where you are. Nothing is happening. Why? You are not applying verse 18 to your life. The Philippian church gave to Apostle Paul. They gave to the work of God. They gave to the ministry of Paul. And in verse 18, out of nothing they gave. And Paul prophesied to their life. He prophesied into their future. He said, my God shall supply all your needs according to riches in glory by Christ Jesus. But today you don't offer anything, you don't give, you don't show that you want to live. Those that want to live better than this show ends up in the prisons. That's the most time someone will call you, hello, I'm so person, I'm your banker, can you give me your BVN? They want to wear your BVN. They are not people working in bank. Those are criminals. Those who don't want to work, they don't want to struggle. So, you are working at the end of the month, you are being presented to us. The same thing is applicable in giving. Just keep giving. It might look as if nothing is happening. Keep giving, keep sowing, keep sowing, keep giving. At the end, the harvest will come. Because when the cloud is full of rain, nothing holds it down for it to fall as rain. There's nothing called rain. There's nothing called rain. But what brings rain is accumulation of was what? Vapor, evaporation. And the sun is shining. There's evaporation taking place, going on. Then when the cloud is full, it cannot hold itself, it starts falling. The same thing is applicable when you're your giver, when you're sower, and when you're tighter. Praise God. I say praise God. Some Christians don't express their rainfall, they don't express their blessing, they don't express their prosperity or their harvest. Until they die. Why? Because the power to let out is not at work in them. Why? Because they don't expect abundance, they don't expect a rainfall until death. Why? The power to let out is not at work in them. The power
walk in them. Give, I don't have. This is only thing I have to eat today. Yes, you can give your last time and look up to God. You want to succeed, you must be a giver. You want to prosper your age, you must be a giver, you must be a sower. Praise God. I said, praise God. Some Christians don't express their red fall on the bed. Why? Because the power to lay down things is not at work in them. The power to sow. The power to sow is not at work in them. Giving power always precedes receiving power. Giving power always precedes the receiving power. Until you give, you don't have the ability or the capability to receive. Sow anything to someone, they can't imagine that somebody sold it. How do you think that man will remain poor? How do you think that man will live beggarly? How do you think that man, a man's children will be vagabond? No, it cannot happen. It is impossible. Sow of them on your children, sow of them on your husband, man of your wife, sow seeds of them on your business and career. Sow of this ministry is a sowing ministry. We sow our seeds to bigger ministries, we sow to the poor. That we can never remain small. I said we know that we can never remain small. We are coming the edge in the name of Jesus. I said we are coming the edge in the name of Jesus. Beloved, we want to succeed, but be a giver, but be a sower. Give, why? Because giving power always precedes the receiving power. Let's quickly look at 2 Corinthians 9 verse 2 Corinthians 9, verse, let me read from King James. Second Corinthians 9, verse 6. Second Corinthians 9, you are just saying, amen. Verse 6. Paul said to them, this I say, he who soweth sparingly shall do what? Shall do what? Reap also sparingly. And he who soweth bountifully shall also reap what? What is sparingly and what is bountifully? See, time and harvest time, you want to sow, let's give for this or that. You see people giving 50 naira. When they give 50 naira, their harvest strong as 500 naira. That's why you're still in the level you are. When you give 1,000, the harvest of 10,000 comes to you. You give 10,000, the harvest of 100,000 comes to your account. When it's so small, you reach small. You want to be rich, you want to be great, you must be, you must so big. You must so big. You must so big. The word of God cannot be broken. God cannot lie. So he that soweth sparingly shall also be sparingly. But he that soweth bountifully big shall also be big. Somebody say amen. Look at what verse 7 says. He said, every man, according as I propose in his heart, let him give, not grudgingly or necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. He loveth a cheerful giver. He loveth a cheerful giver. Praise God. The Lord, givers are winners and rulers. Givers are winners. Givers are rulers. You want to rule your world, then what they give up. Want to be a winner in your life, then you must be a giver. So for example, a farmer who plants his seed gets plenty in return. Is that your boss? Is that your boss? If for instance, if you planted a grain of corn, do you get back a grain of corn? Somebody answered, do you get back a grain of corn? No, somebody said no. You get a bunch of corn. He said this is applicable to kingdom principle. You will never come across a Christian who enjoys plenty that doesn't have the power to lay down. You cannot see a Christian that enjoys in plenty that does not have the power to lay down. That is not a giver. See someone who says, I want to be like Kenneth Copeland. Kenneth Copeland is a giver. I want to be like Bishop Redeko, a pastor who does and you want to be like Rene Moore, you will suffer in that village. You must be a giver. Brothers and sisters must be givers. Pastor Chris is a giver. Those people are giving to him. Today, stop giving. Don't expect it to come back to you. Praise God. I say, praise God. Beloved, moisture doesn't need to be prayed for before it becomes a rain. No, you don't pray out, Lord. Let that know on us. Evaporation is taking place, moisture, things are turning, happening. At the end, when the cloud is full, you don't need to pray for it. First time, it's something happen when you're giving. Just keep giving. If nothing is happening, keep giving, keep sowing, keep sowing, keep sowing. At the end, you get the harvest of God, you don't even expect it. And not be a thing you're expecting it. Givers can never, never lack. Givers can never, never be poor. It can start giving from the level you are. It can start giving from the level where you are now. You have nothing. Give, and God will prosper you. Somebody say, amen. Sow for your job, for your promotion, sow for your leader, sow for your children, sow seeds to become to prosper you. Then he came with all his might and expressed a harvest of rain. Then he came and gave and gave and gave and experienced a bountiful harvest of rain. Making David, he was a giver. Today, David is being celebrated all over the world. Why? Because he was a giver. Abraham was a giver. Isaac was a giver. God said, God told Isaac to sow in the land. So, the same amount of people are running away from. God said, sow. He sowed and prospered the same year. Even his enemies every day. Everybody was running to other cities, running to Egypt, trying to, and God. Isaac wanted to go to Egypt. And God said, Isaac, remember where you are. Listen, it can be in Port Harcourt and rule the world. Somebody say, amen. That means the city. And succeed. It can be on the mission and succeed. It can be in Nigeria and succeed. It must not go to America to succeed. It must not live in Canada to succeed. It must not live in Australia to succeed. It can live here in Africa and succeed. When you apply the power to Nathan, someone say amen. David came with all his might and expressed a harvest of rain. Let's quickly look at 2 Chronicles 29. 2 Chronicles 29, 2 to 8. 2 Chronicles 29, 2 to 8. Second Chronicles 29, 2 to 8. Praise God. Read from the next verse. Read from here. Praise God. Let me read from New Living Translation. That's from 59. Let me read from New Living Translation. From verse 2. Using every resource at my command, I have gathered as much as I could for building the temple of my God, not his own house. For building the temple of my God, now there is enough gold, silver, bronze, iron, and wood, as well as bread, quantities of olives, other precious stones, costly jewels, and all kinds of fine stones, marble. And now because of my devotion to the temple of my God, I am giving all my own private treasures of gold and silver to help the construction. This is in addition to the building materials I have already collected for his holy temple. This one is from his own pocket, not from offering or tithes, not from the contribution they made, from his own pocket. Verse 4, he said, I am donating more than 112 tons of gold from offering and 262 tons of refined silver to be used for overlaying the walls of the building. And for the other gold and silver work to be done by the craftsmen. Now, then, who will follow my example and give offerings to the Lord today? Who will follow my example and give offerings to the Lord today? Verse 6. Then the family leaders, the leaders of tribe of Israel, the generals and captains of the army, and the king's administrative officers, all gave willingly, not only David, his soldiers, his assistant pastors, and everyone, they gave willingly. Everyone that had it gave of a willing heart, so that the house of God can be built. You cannot build the house of God with 10 naira. It was given with all of your strength, all of your might. Give your best to God, and God will give his best to you. Somebody say amen. God gave us his best. He gave us Jesus. It cost him something. Praise God. Verse 7. For the construction of the temple of God, they gave about 188 tons of gold, 10,000 gold coins, 375 tons of silver, and 675 tons of bronze, and 3,750 tons of iron. Verse 8. They also contributed numerous precious stones, which were deposited in the treasury of the house of the Lord, under the care of Jehiel, the descendant of Gershon. Verse 9. The people rejoiced over the offerings, for they had given freely and wholeheartedly to the Lord. And King David was filled with joy. Praise God. I said, praise God. David offered. He gave, and he also stepped up the people to give, and God prospered them. God gave the victory in every battle they fought. Praise God. Solomon gave and gave and gave. His heaven was open. Solomon gave and gave. The son of David. Solomon, the son of David. He gave and gave and gave until his heaven opened. He was the only king that ever fought battle. He was the only king that of Israel that nations came to submit under. God gave him rest, gave him peace, prosper his kingdom. Why? Because he was a giver. He was a giver. Let's quickly look at 1 Kings chapter 23, 3 to 7. Or 3 to 5. 1 Kings chapter 3. 3 to 5. The Bible says in 1 Kings 3, verse 3 to 5, tell Solomon loved the Lord and followed all the decrees. He followed all the teachings of his father David. He followed all the teachings that had been taught in the house of God. He followed all the teachings. Solomon loved the Lord and followed all the decrees of his father David. Except that Solomon too offered sacrifice and burnt incense at the local places of worship. The most in a dream and said, what do you want? Ask and I will give it to you. What did God ask him before this time? He gave a tithe upon offering, something no man has ever given to God, and God smelt it from heaven. Listen, beloved, your offerings can bring the attention of God to you. It was the offering of the widow that brought the attention of Jesus to her. She gave her mask out. So much offering brought the attention of God. And God smelled the offering and said, who have done this? Well, why have you done this? He said, Lord, because I love you. It must give to God because you love him. God also gave to us his only begotten son. Why? Because he loved us. For God so loved the world that he gave. Only those that don't love God and love him. But if you love God, you want to give your all and all. If you love God, you give your house, you give your life, you give your heart, you give your financial, everything you have to God. Why? Because he will reward you at the end. He rewarded Solomon. He gave, and God rewarded him 7 nights. Praise God. Abraham gave and gave, and he gave to a man that has no descendant, whose name is Mephibosheth, the Jesus of the Old Testament. Mephibosheth was the Jesus of the Old Testament. Abraham gave a tithe, 1/10 of his income to him, and he blessed Abraham. God said, bring me all the tithes and your offerings that I never be meet in my house and prove me now. If I will not open the heaven and pray a blessing, there will not be room enough to receive. Say, prove me now. If I will not open you the window of heaven and pray a blessing, there will not be room enough to receive. Then why are you not giving? Why have you decided to be where you are? It been in that place for so long. Today I pray you must come out of that place. I say you must come out of that place in the name of Jesus. So one came out a thousand-pound offering and his heaven opened. Abraham gave and gave and gave to a man that had one descendant. A man that had one father and mother. The Jesus of his time. Praise God. Let's see Genesis chapter 14, 20 quickly. Genesis chapter 14, verse 20. Genesis 14, 20. Let's read from verse 17. Say, after Abraham returned from the victory, listen, after he returned from the victory over Petaloma and all his allies, the king of Sodom went out to meet him in the valley of Shaphat, that is the king's valley. Verse 18. And Meshisele, the king of Salem, the priest of God Most High, brought Abraham some bread and wine. Meshisele blessed Abraham with his blessing, with his blessings, blessed him Abraham by God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, verse 20, and blessed be God Most High, who has defeated your enemies for you. Then Abraham gave Meshisele a tenth of all the goods he had recovered. He gave his tithe, 1/10, to Jesus of his time. A man that no descendant. Praise God. I said, praise God. Let's see Hebrews chapter 7. Hebrews 7, 1 to 4. Hebrews 7, 1 to 4. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 1 to 4. Shall we shout amen? Hebrews 7, 1 to 4. This person was king of the city of Salem and also a priest of God Most High. When Abraham was returning home after winning a great battle against the kings, Meshisele met him and blessed him. Then Abraham took a tenth of all he had captured in battle and gave it to Meshisele. The name Meshisele means king of justice. Who is the king of justice? Jesus. Somebody said Jesus. Somebody said Jesus. He said, was king of justice and king of Salem means king of peace. There is no record of his father or mother or any of his ancestors, no beginning or end to his life. He remains a peace forever, resembling the Son of God. So I said Jesus, resembling Jesus. Consider then how great this Melchizedek was, even Abraham, the great patriarch of Israel, recognize this by giving him a tenth of what he had taken in battle. Put his whatever thing God has given to you, to one tenth belongs back. You return one tenth back to him. Whatever blessings, whatever victory you get, when you go out, you must bring one tenth back to God. Don't eat that belongs to God, so he can prosper your life. Abraham is tied to Melchizedek and he blessed him. And today, Abraham is the father of many nations. We all are sons of Abraham. I prophesy, as you are faithful in your giving, as you are faithful in sowing, in building God's kingdom, you shall prosper in the land in the name of Jesus. You will prosper in the land in the name of Jesus. Somebody said, "Be kept me." God gave and gave until he gave his only son. God owns the whole world, yet he gave Jesus. Mankind would have been redeemed if not like Jesus. God gave us his only son. I'm telling John chapter 3, verse 16, that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. That is just it. Give that God gave to us from life to give us eternal life. Praise God. God is a respecter of nobody. Many today are looking for power to receive. They have not yet received the power to let down. Many today in the body of Christ is seeking for the power to receive. They have not got the power to let down. If you have not received the power to let down, don't expect the power to receive. God gave his son and God by the whole world for himself. God gave his only begotten son Jesus and gave back the whole world. We don't say Abraham gave her last meal to Elijah and she never went hungry until the famine came to an end. It's time for you to give. Give your best to God. Give your time to God. Give your finance to God. Give your heart. Give everything to him. Because all belongs to him. So that you can succeed, so that you can make it in life. Praise God. I want to let you know that life is not for struggling, life is for a living. There's only those that understand the meaning of life that will enjoy it. Praise God. There are people today, even in this ministry, who once they lay their hands on some big money, they begin to negotiate for their tithes. Even here in our church, once money comes into their hand, they stand and say, "Will I pay? How will I pay this money? If I pay this money now, you know, I will be able to achieve this thing." They start negotiating with their tithes. That will belong to God. You want to eat it? How can such a man succeed? And one of the calling witches and wizards. Listen, no witch or wizard can stop a child of destiny. No witches or wizard can stop a fighter, can stop a giver. They can only succeed when you are rebelling against divine guidance. God will bring you all the tithes and say, "No, Lord, I'll bring some. I want to eat some, sell some." How will such a person succeed? And God says, "I will rebuke the devourer, not you, not even your pastor. It's God that rebuke the devourer." When you obey him. When you give your best to him, when you sow seeds, pay your tithes, he will build the devourer for your sake. God is not hungry. God is an opulent God, he's a wealthy God. Not that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. The cattle upon a thousand hills, the silver and the gold belongs to God. So God is not hungry. He's not a bunch of money. He's only teaching the kingdom principles. Succeed on it. So no struggle here. No one has ever seen an error under the sun. Where the pigs are trekking and the servants are riding on horses. Who are servants? Sinners are servants. You that say, "God again, the king, a royal priesthood," you are still trekking. Why somebody in government house who doesn't know Jesus is riding Rolls Royce? It's an error. The preacher called it an error. He said, "I've seen an error under the sun." Beloved, you must keep in this principle. Next Sunday, I'm going to be preaching on kingdom, keys to kingdom prosperity. Keys to kingdom prosperity. You want to succeed in the kingdom as a child of God, you want to make it on earth and also make heaven at last. You must walk in this principle. Praise God. I said, praise God. One money coming into their hand, they need to negotiate their tithes, whether to pay or not, to for fulfilling, or we eat of everything. How do you think it's a better plan? Only you, he puts hand here, he's not working, to promise and fail and not rest, because you have not been faithful with the little that comes to you. Don't eat your tithes. Doesn't matter how small or big. Don't eat it. Return it back to God. It belongs to God. Your tithe is holy. Praise God. Listen to it before I close this morning. Until Solomon built the house of the Lord, he couldn't build his own house. So why are you always talking about yourself? Yourself, you think about the things in the house of God, how to be the house of God. You're always thinking about yourself, you're selfish. Talking about yourself, what to wear, what to wear, what to eat, but this and that, how to be your husband. I will neglect it until you begin to give to
sower.
Giving shall be given back to you. Good measure, pressed and shaken together, and running over shall men give unto your own bosom. But when you don't give, no one remembers you. Praise God. Father, I thank you this morning. Thank you for the hearers of this word. Make every hearer of this word do us in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will bless you. I pray that His grace will rest upon you. In the name of Jesus. This one, I pray that you receive grace to be a giver. Grace to be a kingdom builder. Receive it in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. In Jesus' name. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Next Sunday, I will be preaching on a topic titled The Key to True Prosperity. The Key to True Prosperity. Get ready. Pray as you live here today, you will experience the presence of the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, poverty is far away from you. In the name of Jesus, you will not be poor. I say, you shall not be poor. You will not be poor. You shall not live beggarly. The Lord will make a way for you, and there seems to be no way. In the name of Jesus, this month of July, you shall have a cause to testify. You shall have a cause to praise the Lord. In the name of Jesus, the Lord shall give you a new song. In this month of July, in the name of Jesus, you will succeed in whatever you lay your hands to do. You will succeed in whatever you lay your hands to do. That's business you started will prosper. That little business you started, the little one will expand. I see the hand of God expanding your business. Expanding your career in the name of Jesus. You will succeed. I say you will succeed. I say you will succeed. In the name of Jesus. Beloved, for you to succeed, you must be a giver. Don't be a sower. Praise God. The Lord help us in Jesus' name. Stand on your feet and wave your hands. Give me praise. Just lift your voice. Give God praise. Thank Him this morning for grace you have received. Grace to prosper that you have received. Praise for increase you have received this morning. Lift your voice and give God praise. Hallelujah. Say, Lord, thank you for your word I have had this morning. Thank you for your word. It shall not return unto you void and be accomplished that which I have sent it. Lift your voice and say, Lord, thank you for giving me the grace to be a giver. To be a giver. Give me grace to build your sanctuary as David built for you. As Solomon built, holy Pradia to Shataya, Liparata Sokete Brenebush, Yeta Bariata Basata. Lift your voice and give him praise. Holy Paranabash, Eto Pradianzu, Likabababash, Likabababababa. Open your mouth and begin to appreciate God. Say, Lord, thank you. Give me grace. Give me grace. Grace to be a giver. Grace to be a kingdom builder. Grace to help him fall. Grace to help less marginalized. Only Prani Kalabalaba Shatalaba. Let it be. Jesus into your life. on that level and I heaven that I'll give you rest. And Lord, it's time for you to lay down your life for Jesus. You can never regret for laying down your life. The first thing to give to God, not your money, not your house, but your heart. Your heart. Your heart. Jesus is calling you now. Jesus is calling you. You are still living in sin. You are still living in worldliness. You are still compromised. You are not compromised. Jesus is calling you. He said, come unto me. Come unto me. All in that level of heaven and of the earth. Wherever you are this morning, you want to live your life to Jesus. You need to make acts of mercy. You need to confess your sins. You need to ask the Lord, I'm so sorry. Forgive me for my sins. Lord, please give me all my righteousness. I'm a sinner. I have sinned against you. Forgive me, Lord. Pass through my name, Lord. For the book of flesh. And transform my name to the book of life. Say, Lord Jesus, I receive you this morning. Come into my heart. Come into my heart. Come, come, Lord Jesus. I need you. I cannot succeed without you. I cannot do anything of eternal worth without you. Lord, I surrender to you. I surrender my will. I surrender my loss of my church. I surrender my finances to you. Everything to you, Lord. The glory of my heart. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Somebody shout a living amen. Hallelujah. Put your hands together for Jesus.